The next talk and the next book, which is the book Bustan al-Muhaddithin, The Garden of Hadith Scholars. And as you may well all appreciate, that the Indian subcontinent has been known to be a very prominent place for hadith scholars and hadith ulama. Bustan al-Muhaddithin is written by Al-Imam Shah Abdul Aziz Al-Dahlawi, rahimahullah ta'ala, the garden of hadith scholars. And we all know that Indian subcontinent has been the place and abode where hadith knowledge actually moved away from the Arab world and came into the Indian subcontinent. Great scholars from the Arab world, like the famous Sheikh Abdul Fattah Abu Ghudda, rahimahullah, he states in one of his books that I have to say that the hadith knowledge which once lived in Syria, in Iraq, in Kufa, Baghdad, has now moved away to the subcontinent. And the scholars of hadith today exist in the subcontinent. And this is a subcontinent where from Shah Abdul Aziz al-Dahlawi, rahimahullah, we had great, great scholars of hadith. Till today, we hear these great books of hadith, the Sunan of Abi Dawood, which is a famous collection of hadith. One of the great commentaries of that is Badlul Majhud, compiled by Sheikh Khalil Ahmed al-Sahranfuri, rahimahullah, the teacher of Sheikh Zakaria, rahimahullah. We have Awjazul Masalik, which is the famous commentary on the Muwatta of Imam Malik, written by Sheikh Zakaria, rahimahullah, himself, and many others, and there's quite a few things to say, but time is short. Therefore, I will introduce the next speaker, who is our beloved teacher, whom many of us, many of the students of Darul Ulum Bari studied by. I personally studied hadith, the Sahih of Imam Muslim, with him. And Sheikh Abdul Rahim, Hafizahullah, may Allah bless him, give him a long, long life. He's actually one of the gems of England, a hidden pearl. A lot of times people don't hear about him, but he's one of the pearls of England today, one of the greatest scholars living in the country today, a great scholar of hadith. You shouldn't praise somebody on the face, but he's my teacher, and I think a student can praise the teacher, so I think that's an exception from the hadith. He's a master in the fiqh, in hadith. We studied Sahih Muslim by him. I remember we used to study the commentary, the detailed commentary, the summary that he used to provide for each hadith from the sharah of Imam Muslim, Nawawi's sharah, commentary of Sahih Muslim. He used to quote Imam Ubay, he's got a commentary as well. He used to also quote Takmila Fathul Mulhim and many other commentaries and give us the summary. When we used to write the summary, it's like, you know, the khulasa or the summary from compiled from many commentaries of the Sahih of Imam Muslim. I remember because it was in the afternoon and we used to feel very, you know, afternoon after having rice, we used to feel quite sleepy. Sheikh Abdul Rahim used to have tea and then he used to tell me after having half a cup, he said, Ibn Adam, come here, have this tea, so that I stay awake as well. This is the rahmah and mercy teachers have on their students. He studied at Darul Ulum Bari and then he taught, and he's still teaching at Darul Ulum Bari, teaching hadith there, Sahih Muslim and other books. He has a special attachment with tafsir because after studying, he went to Sahranpur in India, where he studied hadith with Sheikh Yunus, Hafizahullah, and also he did takhassus, specialization in tafsir, specifically learning and teaching of the tafsir of Imam al-Baydawi. And he taught, I studied Baydawi, tafsir al-Baydawi with him as well. And as you know, he has book Ahsanul Qasas, the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, and recently just published, you'll see his book outside, the story of Noah, Sayyiduna Nuh alayhi salam, which he compiled himself, the commentary of that. And also, as Sheikh Mahmoud Chandia mentioned, he teaches Maqamat Hariri, or he was teaching. He's a master of the Arabic literature as well, and a very high position he has in spirituality and tasawwuf, having ijazah from many ulama, and especially our Sheikh, Sheikh Mawlana Yusuf Mutala, Hafizahullah. Inshallah, we'll call upon Sheikh Mawlana Abdul Rahim to give us a lecture on Bustan al-Muhaddithin.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayh. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. Wa nashhadu anna sayyidana mawlana Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluh. Sallallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa baraka wa sallama tasliman kathiran kathira. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحمل هذا العلم من كل خلف عدوله ينفون عنه تحريف الغالين وتأويل الجاهلين وانتحال المبطلين وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام إن الله تعالى يبعث لهذه الأمة على رأس كل 100 سنة من يجدد لها أمر دينها أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما درود شریف پڑھیں ایک دفعہ اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد Respected elders, brothers, friends, ladies, guests listening at home on the internet, Alhamdulillah, it gives me a great pleasure to come here, stand in front of you. And also, after observing all the congregation over here, because this is not just any ordinary type of conference. We are here for a special purpose, inauguration of few books which have been written and which are coming into the market. So you want to know what type of books they are, and you want to learn so you can buy these books and you can benefit from them. This shows the amount of zeal and eagerness you have for literacy. It is a good sign, Alhamdulillah, so many people here who want to know about the books. Because we see in the environment today, people relying on the internet, they want to gain information quickly, nobody wants to read books. Libraries are becoming distinct, going away from the society. So Alhamdulillah, if you have this zeal, we remember the Urdu poet who says, Musalmano na ghabrao, khuda ki shan baqi hai, abhi Islam zinda hai, abhi Quran baqi hai. So Alhamdulillah, may Allah Pak keep this shauq and this zeal and eagerness within us and give us the tawfiq to read good books which are beneficial to us, which can transform us, which can bring changes into our lives. I would like to thank Brother Yahya and Turath Publication for inviting me over here. I would also like to congratulate them for these works they are doing. We pray for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open new ways for them, accept the effort they are making and benefit the whole Muslim Ummah and the mankind as a whole from the works they are doing. Respected elders, brothers, the topic I have been given requires a lot of time. We don't have much time. Maghrib Salat is very near. Bustanul Muhaddithin. First of all, when Maulana Shoaib Mangera told me that, Maulana Sahab, you have to come to London on 7-7, I was just shocked. 7-7 London? No, please. Why? What's on? I said, no, Mustafa, please, do take it easy. We have this gathering congregation. You have to come and give speech. Then I was a bit relieved. Because these days, when you hear something like, you immediately get scared that I don't know what's going to happen. So then when he explained, I was a bit relieved. I say, inshallah, I'll make mashura. I'll see if I can come down. And alhamdulillah, I'm here today in front of you. The topic is Bustanul Muhaddithin, Garden of the Scholars of Hadith. Now, to talk about the book first, you need to know who the author is first. Because you mustn't read any book from anywhere. You must check who the author is, first of all. And only take knowledge from reliable sources. Like Sheikh Yaqubi was mentioning, إِنَّ هَذَا الْعِلْمَ دِينٌ فَانْظُرُوا عَمَّنْ تَأْخُذُونَ دِينَكُمْ This knowledge is deen. So be careful from whom you take your knowledge. Don't just read any book which you find outside. Don't take any information from any website you see on the internet. There is a lot of kabar and kachara outside. So don't just fall for anything. Just, you know, look at the author first and then use and read that book. So we need to know who the author is first. He is Shah Waliullah, son Shah Abdul Aziz Muhaddith Dehlavi Rahmatullahi Alayh. His lineage goes in this way: Abdul Aziz Ibn Ahmad Ibn Abdul Rahim Ibn Sheikh Wajihuddin Al-Umari Rahimahullah Ta'ala. His lineage goes on to connect to Sayyiduna Abdullah Ibn Umar Ibn Al-Khattab Radiyallahu Anhu. So he is from the family of Sayyiduna Umar Radiyallahu Anhu. Maybe the descendants of Sayyiduna Umar Radiyallahu Anhu migrated to India in some later stages, like we have come here over here to England. So from his descendants, say Shah Abdul Aziz Muhaddis Dehlavi and his family have come up. Also on the other side, Sheikh Wajihuddin, who is the grandfather of Shah Waliullah, was a hafid, a maternal grandson of Sayyid Nurul Jabbar al-Mashhadi rahmatullahi alayhi, who was from the descendants of Sayyiduna Imam Musa al-Kazim rahmatullahi alayhi. So in that way, from that side, he is connected to the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam as well. So he himself is from a very noble family. His Shah Abdul Aziz's grandfather, Shah Abdul Rahim Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullahi alayhi, he was among the mashayikh and great scholars of his time. He was part of that committee which was commissioned to author Fatawa Alamgiriya, a huge collection of fatawas according to the Al-Fiqh Al-Hanafi in nearly more than 6 volumes, which has been translated into English by the British government as well some time ago, more than 100 years ago. And so he was a part of that committee which was commissioned for this work. Now he has this son, Ahmad Waliullah. At his later age, when he is about 45 years old, he has Waliullah. Shah Waliullah Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullahi alayhi is born. He grows up under the supervision of his father, Shah Abdul Rahim Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullahi alayhi. He memorizes the Quran at the age of 7. He starts the books of Al-Fawaidul Diyaiya and Persian language at the age of 10. He progresses with Nahu and Sarf and Fiqh and Balagha and all these sciences. And by the age of 14, he is nearly completing his studies. So his father enters him into wedlock, gets him married. So some people comment that, why are you getting him married so soon? Said, well, there is some wisdom, maslihat behind it. And these masalih and wisdom came to light after some time. Because at the age of 15, he graduated from all ma'qul, manqul, usul, furu', hadith, fiqh, and everything was completed. By the age of 16, he had become bay'at to his father and he had gained ascendancy in the silsila of Naqshbandiya, meaning in the suluk as well. And his father gave him ijazah at the age of 16. He's only a boy of 16, as he's been given ijazah by his father. And when he's 17, his father departs from this world. Now this young man has to look after the madrasa which his father had started by the name of Madrasa Rahimiya. And he very eagerly looks after and takes care of that madrasa for a good period of time. In the year 1143, when he is 29 years old, he goes to Makkah Mukarrama for Hajj. Performs his Hajj, stays there for a whole year. The next Hajj, he performs the next Hajj as well. And after that, another 6-7 months, nearly a period of over 2 years, he stays in Makkah Mukarrama. During this period, he goes around the mashayikh of Haramain and he studies hadith by them, especially with Shaykh Abu Tahir al-Kurdi rahmatullahi alayhi, who was a renowned shaykh of that time in that area. He studies all the sihah and whatever he could with Shaykh Abu Tahir al-Kurdi rahmatullahi alayhi. And Shaykh Abu Tahir develops this special love for Shah Waliullah rahmatullahi alayhi, to the extent that sometimes he used to say, kana yastafidu minni lafz wa kuntu astafidu minhu al-ma'na, that Waliullah would gather the words of hadith from me and I would discover the meanings from him. So he had so much love for him and they were so much attached, and he always used to keep him close to himself, and he, whatever he could benefit Waliullah, Shah Waliullah Muhaddis Dehlavi rahmatullahi, he did so. Now when he returns, he is a changed man.